Hey ladies, how are you? So I'm here today with a tutorial or some tips and tricks on how to fix your nails, because I know some of you are at home with some acrylic nails that are growing out and I know you're desperate. But don't panic, because I'm here to help you out. So some of you, I don't have any acrylics on, these are my natural nails, so I'm just gonna show you. Just imagine this to be your nail, your acrylic that is coming up. Can you see this? Can you see this? Yeah, you can see it. You see how it's coming up like that? You have this part, the outgrowing part, and this is your acrylic, right? What you wanna do, grab a nail file, one that is a little bit rough, and you just start smoothing this part down. You just start filing this part down, okay? And you want to like be a little aggressive with this part, but don't, make sure you just don't be aggressive on your natural nail, okay? So you smooth this all the way down like that, like that, like that. Maybe you want to go the opposite side and smooth it down. And once you smoothen this part down with a rough nail file, you want to get a smoother one and start smoothing those parts out, okay? And you just keep going and keep going until you are satisfied with the smoothness from here to here, okay? Now, there are many ways how to fix it. If you feel like that is too much for you already, what you could do is just fill up this part and go over it with a dark color or something that will be thick enough to cover and smooth it out. So from close up, it's not gonna look nicely done. However, from afar, people won't be able to tell that, you know, your nails are falling apart. So if you want to be creative, what you could do is leave this part open like that and get something that's either a contrasting color, darker color, whatever color you like. You pick a color, honey, pick a color, okay? Grab a toothpick, whatever thing you have that has a point, just go over it like this. Grab a good amount of nail polish, rotate it a little bit so you have every area covered, right? And be patient with it. And then you just start filling up this area, okay? If this area is not wide enough and you can't fit it with the brush off the nail polish, then you want to do it with this, okay? Or you could do any decorative thing that comes to mind with this. Trust me, this is a go-to thing right here, okay? If you have the exact same polish that you want to use, you can do that. If you want to use something that is more sheer and iridescent, this would be a good thing. You can tell that it's sheer and iridescent because it has, you can see the brush basically through it. You can see that this part is lighter and this is darker because the brush obviously is black, right? So that's how you're gonna be able to tell that it's a sheer polish. So it's up to you if you wanna do something sheer or if you wanna really like cover it up smoothly, then I would recommend something that is more pigmented and thick like that. You can barely tell that the brush, like right here, you don't see that the brush was black. You see that it's all pink, right? Okay, you could do that. So once you file your nails down, it's to your liking, you start polishing, okay? For those of you who have gel polish, it's harder to take off with regular nail polish, so I would recommend something that has acetone. However, if you don't have a polish remover that has acetone, but you have a regular one, that should work too. What you wanna do, usually the cotton balls, they're like this. I really open them up, push them, and roll them out. That way you have a much more use. You have a lot more use out of this, okay? So I had this piece already. Soak it up. And regular polish, you just go over it a few times and it will come off. Your gel polish, however, will not. Okay, you would have to soak a piece up. Let's say this is just a small piece soaked up. You want to grab a piece of foil and cover it just like that. And let it sit for about 20-30 minutes and then you should be okay. And if it's still not okay, you can always take that off and redo the whole process, okay? If you have a nail polish, like a regular polish that has glitters in it, I would recommend you do the same thing. Cover it up with foil because glitter, that those are just a pain to remove. All right, ladies. Okay, I'm showing you here how I remove it. I just go in circular motions and my nail polish is coming off. Just like a zap. Okay. And then now it's clean. I go to the filing step and I start filing my nails, and you don't want to go like zzz. That's damaging to your nails. You want to be gentle with your natural nails and go in one direction, just like that. Okay. I personally like my shape to be square. I have been wearing my nails in a square shape for years now. It's just my go-to. I feel like my nails break less when they are square, but a round shape lasts longer. I will say that. You guys can't really see what I'm doing, but I'm just still filing it a little bit. After doing that, again, I am taking a nail file that's a little bit smoother. And I'm going over it just a few times. Okay, once you have your nails filed, you want to push back your cuticles. I usually just push it down with my nails. You can use the tools, but I don't find that to be very effective or as much as pushing it down with my nails. Okay, once that is done, I recommend you use a base coat that will protect your nails from the chemicals that may be in nail polish, or it nourishes your nails. Some of them have garlic in them. Some of them, garlic actually causes your nails to grow, so, or strengthen it. And some of them have organ oil in it. Organ oil is really good for us. So, let's see, I think, let me turn this down. I created this little messy area right here. So, just like that, I am going to go down. You want to start at the top and smooth it down, okay? Go on the top, smooth it down. So these three fingers, I already put a base coat on. And honey, I need to pick a color. I pick this color, honey. You pick a color at home, honey, and then you do your nail and I'll help you polish your nail virtually, okay, honey? This is my color. And again, I start at the top, smooth it down. I usually start in the middle because once you start in the middle, you can smooth it to the sides.
of your nail. As you can see, this polish is also pretty sheer, which is okay. I do 2 coats every time I polish my nails. And if it's very sheer, I may do like 3 coats. That will usually do it. Okay. I know you guys see my hands shaking. Now here comes the harder part. When you're doing your right hand, you have to figure out what works for you. It may work for you to just go like this and be still and find a good position for your wrist, your left wrist to be in, so you can like smooth it. And you may have to really move your whole left arm, or you might have to keep the brush still like that and move your right hand away from the brush. Okay, just find what works for you. Just like that. Now, but I'm gonna go back and actually polish these 2 fingers. So, my left hand is done for now. What you wanna do, ladies, is just sit down, relax. Don't touch a single thing and do not blow on your nails because it will cause the upper layer to dry. But whatever's on the bottom, oh my God, I'm doing too much. Whatever's on the bottom just won't dry. So it will remain very thick. And when, even when you're thinking that 2 hours later it's dry, it's really not. So just sit down, stay pretty, and just wait for a few seconds, okay? These are almost dry. The ones that I did at first. So... I guess I'm gonna start talking to you guys about my day. My day was good. I went outside because I had to go ship off some masks that I made. And it was 25 Celsius outside today. So it was really, really good. I had a blast walking. It was far. I thought, oh, it's gonna be like just a 20-minute walk. I could do that. And then I started walking and oh my God, girl. It was far. It was so far. I was like, whew, when am I gonna arrive? And then I finally got there and the store was pretty empty, so I shipped it off. Girl was taking her good little time helping me out. It was okay because I didn't have anything to do anyway. Now, and then as soon as I walked in the store, I had to cough, right? So I'm like trying not to cough. But then I was like, shoot, I'm not gonna die over here trying not to cough. So I started coughing little by little. And then there was this man in the store and he was like, don't you start coughing now. So I started laughing, right? Then I walk outside, I start coughing again. And I go like this, right? So there's this lady in her car. She's like, so she gets her whole head out of the window like, I saw that. And I started laughing. I was like, yeah, you saw that. So, yeah. Then I came back home and started cleaning. And then I started cooking, which you guys, I'm sure you have seen in my story anyway. So, I made some fried rice and some squash on the side and a cucumber salad on the side. It was good. It was so good. How was your day? Comment it below. Why not? Yep, so... yeah, these are the first 3 that I did are dry, so we could go ahead and polish that again. So, gonna have it like, let me just start over here. I hope you guys could see it because I don't wanna adjust my phone again. Being lazy right now. Okay, this is how it looks. It's a pretty color. It's OPI. And I'm gonna read the color name to you in a minute. Just give me one moment. And you wanna really make sure that your nail is dry before you put on a second coat. That way it's not gonna take forever for it to dry. Okay. This is exotic birds do not tweet. And it's so cute. I love it. I like it. I like it. Let's see. Oh, needs to dry too, so I can go ahead. And finding a good top coat is pretty hard. A lot of them say fast drying, but then once you put it on, it will take like 7 hours for it to dry. And then you wake up the next day with all these little scratches in it. I do not like. So this is the kind that I use. It says Seche Vite. I don't know if that's how you pronounce it. But it's a fast dry top coat that I bought at a beauty supply store. I think it's Sally, but it's in Fayetteville. And I have never seen this one anywhere else. But this is like magic in a bottle. It dries within seconds. And once it's dry, it dries to like a thin layer. As to where some of them dry and it's like thick, right? And then I have this matching base coat to go with it that I used earlier. So I highly recommend this. There are other brands that are good. I have this one from Sally Hansen. It's like a double duty and it's a base and top coat. This is great as a base coat. It's great to use by itself. Like, I would not wear this base coat by itself because it will have this sticky feel to it like a lot of base coats do. But this one will function as a regular clear polish. I hate this one as a top coat. It feels like it will just never dry. This is one that will take 25 hours to dry and then you wake up with these scratches that I've talked about earlier. But if you want to use this just as a base coat and just by itself without anything on top, no color on top, just like a base coat and clear polish, perfect. Yeah, oh, I might as well just polish these two as well. Yeah, it's so pretty, I like. And I usually smooth out the brush against the neck of the bottle to make sure I don't have a lot of polish on the brush all at once. And if you feel like it's not enough, you can always go back into the bottle and pick up a little bit more. But you don't want to put on too much at one time. I'd rather do several thin layers. That way it dries quicker and it dries evenly. Just like that. Make sure you close your bottles so that there's no air getting into it, causing it to get thick quickly. Quick. And then you just find something to do in the meantime that will not require you to use your hands. So stare at a wall
watch TV, binge watch something. Talk to whoever's in your house. Talk their ear off. And sometimes it helps to just fan. I don't know why fanning works, but blowing on it doesn't work. That's weird because it's still, you know, requiring, it's still wind. I think maybe it's the carbon dioxide. Is that? I don't know if that's how you say that in English. We say coal stuff dioxide, okay? So forgive me, okay? Bilingual over here. So I think maybe that's the reason why blowing on the nails will not dry, but fanning or just having a fan blow air on it will work. Or, you know, like the little shh. I need to invest in one of those. And I'm gonna tell you guys, since we're just sitting here having girl talk, one of my goals actually is to go get my license and be a nail tech. I think that would be really cool. I used to be into nail art a lot when I was like 15. I was super girly growing up, so whenever I would have a birthday or something special and people would give me gifts, my cousins and my aunts, sometimes my mom, they would give me like this little kitty thing with makeup and nail polishes, and I would do my nail polish, but I would get so upset because the nail polishes would be the prettiest things ever with glitters in them. I love glitter. But then as soon as you wash your hands, the whole polish is gone. So I'm like, what is this, soap? And I remember clearly one time I got so mad because it was like, what? Y'all just won't let me be great. And then they would have the fake nails that you could just put on, and it's like a sticker. So it's, you have a fake nail, but it has a sticker that keeps it onto your own nails, right? And then I move, and then I see my hand is naked again. I'm like, y'all playing with me. So it started when I was like really little, but when I was 15, I remember having to write a whole research, and it was in groups. So I had one classmate that I was doing it with. She did hair and I did nails and makeup. And then having to do that research opened me up to what all can be done with nail polish and how people use it. And then I learned about nail art. So I started to do nail art on myself, and people were like, oh my God, this is so cute. So then I started to do it on my friends and my cousins. And after that, I just developed this whole thing for nails, and now I'm at a point where I'm like, I should really be a nail tech. I think that if I wasn't into fashion, I'd probably be a cook, a chef, or a nail tech. What about you? Comment it below. So here's my top coat. When you touch your nails to see if it's dry, make sure it's like a very smooth touch that you're doing. If it feels kind of sticky, that means it's still not dry. So you want to sit back and relax a little longer. Okay. Yeah. What do I tell you guys? Things that I've done in nail art, like the American flag, the flag from UK. On my cousin, I think I did the Guyanese flag one time. I have done the water marble. That was so much fun because you like do whatever design in water, and then you dip your finger in it and you come back up, and when you come up, it's that design is just on your nails, like magically on your nails. That is cool. Or I did like the water splashes and did different contrasting colors, did ombre. Yeah. Okay, so this is dry. Again, you start at the top and you smooth it down to the bottom.
And don't worry if you have like, can you see that, these messy edges? Usually I scratch it off when I'm in the shower, because you know, with it being soaked in water, it will come off so quick. Let me see, let me just put this down like that again so you could see what I'm doing. Okay, and before you start, I'm not sure if I said it before, but you want to make sure, look guys, I messed this part up already over here. It's okay. You want to make sure you do not have any oils on your nails, because that will cause the nail polish not to stick on. And because I started with this one and worked that way, I'm going back here. But I would highly recommend that you start, when you're doing your left hand, start with your pinky. That way, this hand, your right hand won't get on the other fingers. And when you do your right hand, you want to make sure that you start with your thumb so that you work your other way, the other way, like the opposite way, right? Does that make sense? No, you want to do the same thing. You want to start here, work this way, so that, because if you start with your thumb and you go that way, while this is still drying, you may get on there by accident. So work this way rather than this way. All right. And remember, do not blow on it. Just sit tight, let it dry. I hope this was helpful. Let me know if you guys have any questions. DM me, call me, email me if you're desperate. So bye, thank you for watching, and let me know, thumbs up, like, double tap, do whatever you gotta do, sis, make this thing work. If you have questions about how to fix your nail and what to do or whatever, if YouTube and Google ain't got the answers, honey, I'm right here. Okay, bye.